On this battlefield, the Chinese army is assisting the Koreans against the Americans. Chinese soldiers talked about a mysterious shooter. He shot an American senior lieutenant sitting on a military tank. From a distance of 1 kilometer, they just only knew that his name was Du Chuan. He was the leader of a scout team, combating at the first line of the theater of war. What a legend. But just only the Chinese soldiers coming here to assist knew that. The scout team was lost for 3 days. Their mission was to take the scout team back. Hopefully they could save some missing soldiers. On the way, they went to an abandoned village. There were a lot of dead bodies, which were the scouting soldiers. There are 28 people in total. Nobody knew how devastating that battle was. They could just guess the direction based on how the dead bodies were on the ground, and hoped that there would be somebody alive. They kept going forward and suddenly found a group of American Army Force. There were 2 tanks assisting, followed by a bunch of trucks delivering materials. They lay in ambush, silently observing. The leader told them not to shoot, because their mission was not killing the rival but bringing their teammates home. Unexpectedly, there was a sound of gunshot from the other side of the mountain. A shot resounded, a gunman died. A few next gunshots exactly shot the rivals who were inside the tanks, through a small observing hole in the front. Just only the great shooter, Du Chuan, can have this amazing shooting technique without doubt. Based on the gunshot, the scout team started attacking. The American reinforcements also started shooting. The American soldiers were being attacked from both sides, which made them suffer a great loss. Although they were equipped well, even had tanks, they still needed to retreat. But as soon as the American soldiers retreated, a distant firecracker base started shooting heavily. This killed a lot of Chinese soldiers. The scout team and the reinforcements had to retreat as well. Then they both gathered together. The scout team had only a few people left, but Du Chuan didn't want to come back with them, because he knew that the American firecracker base had to be destroyed. Otherwise, this would be the biggest threat to the Chinese regular troops. He proposed to destroy it together, but the leader of the reinforcement team came up with a better way. Make a contact the headquarters, ask them for weapon support based on the location that he would provide, to destroy their firecracker base. After saying that, the leader immediately walked to a spacious area, and was about to call the headquarters. A bomb that abruptly came did not only kill him, but also knocked down the only radio transmitter that they had. Then, the soldiers were trying to bring their leader's body home no matter what. This hurt them so much, but they could just only bury him under a dark mountain, because it was very easy to be bombed in this big area. The rest of them decided to follow Du Chuan, using their guns to break up the rival's bombs. To be honest, everybody knew that they would never be able to come back, because their rival had bombs, gun shooters, guards, thousands of warriors and strong firepower. But the scout team just only had a bunch of people who didn't care about death. Would they be able to win if they only had military knowledge and their unity? When seeing the scout team watchtower, Du Chuan knew for sure that was going to be their main point. Their position was higher than the American. They could take the initiative if they knocked down the American tower. The American firecracker base was their intention, but that was not enough. They needed stronger fire. Therefore, they aimed straightly to the trucks that were left by the American through telescope. There was thick steel on top and the flat tires. They knew for sure that there would be good materials inside. At this time, it was lightning, the rain was coming. This was such a great advantage for them. A few hours later, the scout team secretly came to the trucks in the rain. There were certainly a lot of cannons in the trucks. The Americans came after that. They also seemed to wish for taking their materials back in the rain. They had more people, their fire was also stronger. So both immediately started fighting. Du Chuan was leading the scout team, both fighting and retreating. Before leaving, they exploded every single truck, so that the Americans couldn't get any materials from here anymore. The next day, the Americans contacted a nearby squad. A group of gun shooters who were equipped the best guns were invited to the battlefield to assist, because the Americans expected that there would be an ambush coming. Expectedly, the scout team actually started. Before the sun rose up, bombs and gun shooters were all ready. The battle started. The first bombs destroyed the tower. The second chute was sent straight to the American barracks. The Americans immediately gathered together and got ready to fight back. But then another bomb was sent. A lot of people have died. The scout team also shot by their guns. Up to the mountain, Du Chuan brought his shooting skills into play. Every single shoot killed every single opponent. When the battle was getting intense, the professional team from the American came. They were hiding in different places on the mountain. Firstly, they knocked the firecracker team down, which forced the bombing to stop. This time, the soldiers that were hiding in the barrack all running outside. Then the squad was aiming to kill the scout team in the front. The shooters who were able to shoot in long distance, as well as much more powerful bullets, made the scout team suffer serious loss. Du Chuan reluctantly had to force his soldiers to retreat. The rival was determined to catch and kill them. At this time, the American was using a bad tactic. They shot to a soldier to his leg in order to make his teammates come and save him. Expectedly, his teammate actually was turning around to help. But he, unfortunately, got aimed by an American shooter. Then he died immediately. The injured soldier didn't want to make his teammate sacrifice for him anymore. He picked his gun up and was about to kill himself, but then he got shot to his finger. The other teammates quickly threw a bomb to where he was laying, in order to stop the rival from seeing them, simultaneously pulled the injured man away. After the smoke has gone, they lost another teammate while saving the injured one. There were 2 people who sacrificed to save him, but when they were back to the base, This injured soldier has also gone because of losing too much blood. Many people may ask, is it worth it? But actually, the ones who gave up their life for somebody had never measured human lives by number. They just followed their heart. Nobody's judgment could be more highly valued than this noble attitude. The American sent another squad to attack, wanting to destroy the scout team. This squad has done a lot of similar missions. Thousands of Chinese and North Korean soldiers has been murdered by them. There were not many people in the scout team at that moment. Du Chuan knew that they couldn't knock the barrack down, but he could predict that the enemy would come and attack. This sounded like the dead end, but this could be an opportunity, because the squad must bring their radios while attacking. Those radios were the main intention. Five soldiers decided to stay, to fight against the professional American armed force that was equipped well. Luckily, Du Chuan was still wise at combating, so they would never let the enemy do whatever they wanted. The bomb trap was ready. The strings that lead the bombs to explode were also set, and ready to fight. The squad was well experienced, and had a variety of techniques. They divided into two groups. One team was responsible for walking, the other was hiding on the mountain to shoot. This was their most familiar and effective way to fight. But Du Chuan had already planned to defend. First of all, he and his teammates would shoot everywhere in the barrack to distract the shooters. Expectedly, those shooters were aiming everywhere, but none of them was right. Next, they would set the dry grass in the barrack on fire. This made it even more challenging for the shooters to aim correctly. At that time, the first trap exploded. It looked like a rival has stepped on it and died. Therefore, the rest of the rival didn't dare to move forwards, so they started throwing bombs at the barrack. A soldier from the scout got killed by the dense bombs, but this bombing also caused some troubles for their shooting. Not long after, when the Americans walked in the trap, Du Chuan, hiding in the wreckage, commenced shooting. He killed whoever he saw. The place where he was hiding was too magical that none of the American shooters could aim. The Americans couldn't stand anymore, so they walked away from where they were hiding and decided to actually battle. Then the scout team found that there was a rival having a radio with him. This was their main target. Following this, the soldiers immediately chased, attacked him, and even got killed to death. After a few people had sacrificed, a soldier and the army doctor finally got the radio, but then the rival then understood what they actually wanted. Everybody started chasing them, so the scout team had to run away first. In order to support the army doctor to escape, the soldier that got the radio with her had to stay, and unfortunately, he got murdered. When Du Chuan realized the sound of gunshot faded out, he knew that he had to assist his teammates then, so he was leaving with his teammates. They had killed every single rival who didn't pay attention to them. Eventually, they reached the side of the mountain. Du Chuan saw the army doctor running on the mountain slope. At that time, the squad's leader also appeared behind their back. His shooting technique was amazing. Then Du Chuan and his teammate could just only hide in a nearby hole. The army doctor got shot in her leg by the rival's leader. Oh shit, they didn't have any more time. Life or death must be decided now. Du Chuan called his teammate and gave him signal. This was the last chemistry between him and his teammate. After giving the signal, he suddenly stood up. The most powerful shooters from both sides battled, but his purpose of standing up was not to kill him, but to distract him. When his teammate also stood up to kill the rival's leader, Du Chuan got shot too. The great shooter Du Chuan didn't win in his last shoot, but he traded his life with the spirit of gun soldiers, simultaneously spreading it to the future generation. Everything has been done. The army doctor made a contact through radio and sent the location of the enemy's barrack to the headquarters. A bunch of cannons were sent to destroy this barrack. Do you still remember? The enemy had cannons, great shooters, and watchtowers. But the scout team just only had a bunch of people who didn't care about death. But these unknown heroes have dyed the mountain red. They completed a mission that seemed to be impossible. I hope that the world will always be peaceful.